That is a very good question. Fear is highly motivating for humans. I suspect they won't give up. Just then, the glass and metal door to the stairwell opened, and who should step in but Mrs. Zehetofer. Her English teacher, tall, pinched-faced, with hair Caitlin had been surprised to discover was orange. Caitlin, shouldn't you be in class? Caitlin looked up at her and sat up straight. Mr. Auerbach, excuse me. She made a show of rubbing her stomach. I'm not feeling well. My mom's coming to pick me up. You're going to miss another English class? In fact, Caitlin had missed the same number of her classes. Sorry about that. Well, I hope you feel better soon. She started to walk up the stairs. Mrs. Zehetofer stopped and turned. Yes, about Big Brother, I don't necessarily think our side is going to end up like that. It's time for some new thinking. On this issue, Mrs. Zehetofer surprised her by sitting down next to her on the step. What do you mean? Well, I know you don't like science fiction, Caitlin said, but for years there was this thing in SF called cyberpunk. Sure, said Mrs. Z, William Gibson and all that. Oh, you know that, Caitlin said, and only realized it was probably a rude thing to say after the words were already out. Sure, Gibson is Canadian. I saw him right at Harbourfront. Ah, well, I was looking this stuff up. Gibson's book came out in 1948, or the real 19, 1984, the year of 1984. Just when personal computing was getting started, and it predicted that the future of computing was going to be in the hands of an underground of streetwise youth. Cyberpunks, right? But that's not the way it turned out. Everybody uses computers these days. If the prophets of the real 1984 couldn't predict the way our future turned out, if their negative vision turned out to be false, then why should we still assume that someone like Orwell, writing 1948 before widespread television, before much in the way of computing, before the internet, before the web, will eventually turn out to be right? Mrs. Z nodded and said, I remember when time named you. All of us who live our lives online and create content as person of the year. She smiled. I updated my resume to say that named Time Magazine's Person of the Year. I think that's what got me the job as department head. The two CSIS agents did indeed come to the Parameter Institute next, and Malcolm brought them up to the fourth floor collaborative area. One wall was mostly covered by a blackboard. The opposite wall had a fireplace. No, don't touch that. The comfortable chairs are pure. The comfortable chairs and cushions were all upholstered in matching red leather. The floor was blonde hardwood, and there were floor-to-ceiling windows looking down on the courtyard. Forgive us for this interruption, said La Fontaine, sitting in one of the chairs, but we're aware of your family's involvement with the entity called Wemine. How? Actually, said La Fontaine, it was one of our international allies who uncovered it. As you can imagine, we are all vigilant in matters of internet security, especially after the Chinese aggression last month. Now, if you'd kindly let us know how this webmaster is physically created. Why? Malcolm was looking at the hardwood, noting an unfortunate scratch in it. He had no idea if La Fontaine's expression had changed, but his tone certainly had. Because, as I'm sure you can appreciate, an emergent AI, my AI might present a threat. Because there is all sorts of sensitive information on the web. Because, sir, it's our job to be on top of things. Malcolm said nothing, and after a moment, La Fontaine spoke again. Look, Professor Dector, we're sympathetic to the issue, really, we are. I have a doctorate in computer science. Where? Said Malcolm. Where did I study? Undergraduate at Université Laval. Grad school at the University of Calgary. When? I received my PhD in 1997. Again, it really is imperative that we debrief you about this. It's SOP. It's SOP. Malcolm briefly looked up. What? Standard operating procedure, said La Fontaine. Although, I grant you, nothing like this has ever happened before. Still, we don't wish to use a stick when we might offer a carrot. Your work permit is temporary, and your wife's, as I understand it, is tied up in red tape. Obviously, it's in the interest of Canada to expedite any immigration and employment issues related to the two of you. Malcolm caught the spreading of La Fontaine's arms out of the corner of his eye. Believe me, we are always happy to see the brain drain working in reverse for a change. Perhaps your wife will like a job with Wilfrid Laurier? Malcolm said, who? But he actually knew the answer. That was the name of the smaller of the two universities here in Waterloo. In fact, he even knew that Wilfrid Laurier had been the 7th Prime Minister of Canada and that he'd looked into academic immortality when Royal Lutheran University had changed its name to something secular in order to secure public funding, and they hadn't wanted to throw out the monogrammed towels. Malcolm felt his heart racing, not because he was frightened by the CSIS agents, but rather because he was running out of rhetorical ammunition. There hadn't been a lot of treatment available for autistics when he'd been a teenager, but one of the therapists had memorized the Kipling poem that began, I kept 6 honest serving men. They taught me all I knew. Their names are what and why and when and how and where and who. The therapist had told him when he needed to talk to strangers to just ask those questions. Most people, he said, would be happy to answer at length. But now he had to say something more. After taking a deep breath, he said, all right, he said, since you asked, WebMind is an emergent quantum computational system based on a stable null sigma condensate that registers decoherent things to constructive feedback loops. He turned to the back blackboard, scooped up a piece of chalk, and began writing rapidly. See, he said, using Dirac notation, if we let WebMind's default conscious state be represented by a bra or phi, and a cat of fire, bra of fire and cat of fire, then this would be the unselective basis. Means eigenbasis. Oh, lovely. Bra of fire and cat of fire. And the chalk flew across the board again. Now we can get the vector basis of the total combined one-minute alpha state consciousness system by tensor multiplying the basis vectors of the subsystem together. Oh! Now we can get the vector basis. Now we can get the basis vectors of the total combined alpha state consciousness tensor multiplying the basis vectors of the subsystems together. Of course, the unitary of time evolution demands that the total state basis remains orthonormal, and since consciousness requires no stop, Claire, requires a superposition of. I'm not following, said LaFontaine. Malcolm allowed himself a small smile. Ludwig Silberstein always said to Arthur Eddington, "You must be one of the three people in the world who understand relativity." To which Eddington replied, "I'm trying to figure out who the third person is." He turned and did manage to hold LaFontaine's gaze for a moment. "Actually, I suspect there are a few people in this building who might follow this too. How widely would you like me to disseminate information about Wendmine?" Hmm?